let's talk about types of maps. Millions of unique maps are used through the world. Most of those maps can be placed in one of two groups: reference maps and thematic maps. Reference maps show the location of geographic boundaries, physical features of Earth, or cultural features such as places, cities, and roads. Political maps, physical maps, road maps, topographic maps, time zone maps, zip code maps are always examples of reference maps. A variety of reference maps can be created for almost every country in the world. So thematic maps shows the variation of topics the theme across the geographic area. Weather maps show daily high temperature, all those examples of thematic maps. They are made by start with a reference map, the United States, so the temperature plotted as a reference map using colors to communicate the temperature forecast. One common map is the political map, as you can see here. So the political maps are among the most widely used reference maps. They mount in the walls of classrooms to the world. They show the geographic boundaries between governmental units, such as countries, states, and counties. So also they show roads, cities, and major water features, such as oceans, rivers, and lakes. So political maps help people understand the geography of the world. They are used the first type of map that students are introduced into school. You remember your first one? They are also known as reference maps because people refer to them again and again as they have questions. The next map is the topographic map. Topographic maps are reference maps that show the shape of Earth's surface. They usually do with lines of equal elevation, known as a contour lines. But elevation can also be shown using colors. So the color gradient, shade relief, or number of other maps. Topography maps are frequently used by hunters, hikers, skiers, and other sink outdoors recreation. They are also essential tool for trade for geologists, surveyors, engineers, construction, and so on, especially people in the military. The next one is the weather maps. So people who use incredible number of weather maps, they are used to show predicted temperatures, precipitation, storms, warnings, and all kinds of wind speed and direction, chance of precipitation, type of precipitation, snow accumulation, and so on. So all these weather maps are continuous update to communicate the most current information. They are the world's most frequent consulted thematic maps. Did you know about that? So weather maps are present in newspaper, television, and so on. So delivering weather maps on websites and through web apps give people around the world instant access to weather information. Other type of maps will be the time zone maps, geologic maps, and finally the zip code maps. Do you know there's a zip code map? So next time you send a letter, check the zip code. Our last topic in this chapter is Remote Sensing and Geographic Information System, GIS. So Global Position System, or just GPS, is the global navigation using satellites, with at least 4 satellites, a receiver, and algorithms provide location, velocity, and time synchronization for air, sea, and land travel. The satellite system consists of 6 Earth-centered orbital planes. So what is GPS, and explain how that works. So in general, they have some 5 keys. Location, determining a position. Navigation, getting from one location to another. Tracking, monitoring objectives and personal movement. Mapping, creating maps of the world. And timing, making it possible to take precise timing measurements. So GPS is extremely relevant today and used in numerous industries and preparing accurate surveys and maps, taking precise time and so on. So some applications, GPS applications, include emergency response, entertainment, health and fitness, construction, and transportation. So what is remote sensing and what is used for? So remote sensing is the science to obtain information without physically being there. Think about your natural remote sensors. So how you see? So remote sensing is the process of detecting and monitoring the physical characteristic of area by measuring its reflected and emitted radiation at a distance from the target area. Special camera collect remotely sensed images from Earth, which help research sense things about Earth. There are two types of remote sensing, active and passive one. So the active remote sensing system sends a beam of energy on the surface and analyzes the energy reflected back, like flash photography, LiDAR. The passive remote sensing system records wavelength of energy radiant from surface, normal photography, maybe, or eyes. So some examples are cameras and satellites, airplanes take images from large areas. So all then has been very useful to see things not only in the ground but underneath. For example, the sonar system on the ships can be used to create images for the ocean floor without needing to travel to the bottom of the ocean. Cameras on satellites can be used to make images of temperature changes in the oceans. And some specific can be used, for example, large forest fires can be mapped from space, allowing rangers to see much larger area from the ground. Tracking clouds to help predict the weather or watch erupting volcanoes, and help watch the dust storm. So tracking the ground, the growth of a city and changes in farmland or forests over several years or even decades. So this mapping the ocean helps to see our planet in much more detail from the bottom of the ocean to the top of the mountains. So finally, what is GIS? So GIS is a geographic information system, is a computer system, and display that data related to positions on Earth's surface by relating seemingly unrelated data. So how that happen? So they organize in terms of layers, and you can see in these layers special patterns and relationships. So GIS technology is a crucial part to your day house. So you use for every day, find your restaurant or find the best way to get from one place to another one. So GIS can be used in many locations. So for example, used for latitude, longitude, address, or zip codes. So many types, different types of information can be compared and contrasted using GIS. The systems include data about people, population, income, education level, that include information about landscape, such as location of streams, different kinds of vegetation, different kinds of soil. Also, many other information can be used today. And this technology uses layers, as you can see. When you combine different layers you put together in the same georeference, they can be used to analyze. For example, when you open your Google Map, you're looking for the nearest restaurant, they give you information, for example, how far is the restaurant, what type of the food they have, what the reviews for that restaurant, you can access the website. Everything is GIS. So overlay all these maps and use location as the key index, so variable to relate is seemingly unrelated data. So spatial relationships in GIS can be used to display spatial relations in linear network. So for example, display topography, agricultural fields and streams can use for land use patterns and so many ones. So next time you check your cell phone, you look at the maps, find any place, think about GIS.